Welcome, this is the energy vibration laser for all sun, moon, and rising Capricorns. This is the 14th week of the year 2014, and the week begins from the 3rd of April until the 9th of April. It is a wonderful week for you earth element people. This week has been thrumping for you earth element people. It's all about the arcanas coming in and helping you. So the energy vibration of the week is the moon. It's the moon energies, and what this is bringing in for all you earth people is the sun, the world, victory and success. Oh my God, I've seen something. Oh my gosh, okay. I'll explain to you. I've seen something, a recurring thing for the energy vibration of the hurt people. The Virgos also have the Queen of Cups and the Queen of Pentacles in the same position. Oh my God, this is something. This is something. We also have, this is something. There is something about you earth sign people with the energy vibration of the energy of the water people. And what I'm seeing here for you guys, but first I have to break the week down. The week energy, as I said, it's the moon. It's a week of intuition. A lot of clarity is going to come. But I don't see really clarity for you guys. I see the star, the sun, and the world. So a lot of successful, big triumphant success, because triumphant, the Ace of Swords is here. And you have triumph over a huge obstacle, or things that was beyond your own reason and control. You have triumphed that over. Your own energy vibration is on Friday. You're looking at the pentacles, and this is wonderful. There's the energy vibration reading energy for a water woman who is here, and this water energy, because she was in the energy vibration of the in the same position for the Virgo people, and she comes back in this reading for the Capricorn in the same position. There is something happening to this water sign. You Capricorns with the water sign people, there is a situation, because here we have the energy vibration of the Knight of Cups. So this is also another sort of a energy that is coming in that you need to be aware of, because this energy vibration is going to, there is something about the energy of the Knight of Cups and this queen. It's as if he has two mothers. One is of a water sign, one is of a pentacle sign. This is something, and your energy vibration is the Two of Cups. Your energy vibration is the Two of Cups. Wow, isn't this beautiful? Isn't this beautiful? So a lot of emotional, but for some people I'm getting the energy of love, a lot of love, a lot of love and emotions. I'm getting the energy vibration of love, a lot of love and emotion stuff is going on. I love this reading for you Capricorns. I love this reading. Okay, the energy vibration, we have the world, which is the number three. We have the stair, which is six, and one is seven. It's all about new beginnings. It's all about new. It's all about newness. It's as if love is coming in. It's all about the newness of situation that is happening in our lives. Your Capricorn is about to embark on relationship with water sign people. And if you're looking for your twin flame, your soulmate or whatever, and you have met someone of a water sign, you Capricorns, it's the right match. It's the right decision to make. It's the right place to go, okay? Whatever situation that is going on, there is an healing that is taking place with the Queen of Cups and this Capricorn woman. And this Capricorn woman has turned her back on it, because what is happening is that you have gone through so much things. As we break down the week on Monday, We have the energy of the sun. This is wonderful. This is powerful. The energy of the sun that is beginning the week. And this is so wonderful. This is so good. I'm hoping that I get these videos up on time. Because the sun energy for you Capricorns is going to do you a wonders of good. Monday you're going to realize that somehow the cleansing of something is finally out of your life for good. And this is good. On Tuesday, we have the energy vibration of the sword. You have the Ace of Sword and you're slaying the beast with this sword. You are slaying the beast, whoever that was, who has been blocking your life. Somehow the universe comes in and you use that sword on the two blade and you're slaying the beast out of your life. And this is going to be changes. As I said, this, the 3x5 comes up, so transformation is coming in. As we look forward and we look at the middle of the month, we have the energy of the world. The world stands here, and this is wonderful new energy, new vibration, wonderful energies that are coming in that is going to support us in wonderful new ways. Situation is going to happen to us. Doors are going to open up to us. Success is going to come at us. And if you don't have outlook success, you're going to have inner success for you Capricorns out there. So not all the time that when I say success, each and every person have success getting over something and having a successful thing, that you can stand up for your own, that you let go of some pain. That is a successful, that is real good inner success when you can do that. As we look at Thursday, we have the energy of this water woman. Whatever this woman is, she has been coming up in all the earth signs. Be aware, you can have the energy vibration of her. It can be that some Capricorn men are connecting with this sign, because it's the earth sign. Earth and water is very good. So she can be in for the love reading, the love section for you Capricorn men, that you connect to a water sign woman. Can be a Cancer, and yet still it can be a Pisces or a Scorpio, but she is here, so it can affect a lot of people in different ways. You are on Friday, you're going to be blooming. You know, on Friday you're going to be extreme, you're going to be out there, you're going to be blooming, you're going to be getting out there, you're going to be showing things, and you're going to be satisfied with who you are. On Saturday, the energy of the star comes out, you're wonderful, you're threading it. And on Sunday, the night of Chalice is here. So expect a charming young man to come in your life on Sunday. Open up your arms to him and let him in, because he is going to be there for a very, very long time. Your focus for this week is good for business, good for love. It's one of those wonderful times. The last and final card I have for you guys, oh my God. Congratulations, you Capricorn. And I'm sorry, your reading is great. Look at that rainbow. Milk and honey. Look at that rainbow. Milk and honey. Wonderful. Blessing of abundance coming in. Oh my God, the number 51 card. 501 is 6. Okay, I'm sorry guys, but I really, really, really have to let you have this one, because it's beautiful. It's one of those beautiful week, and it's one of those beautiful cards that is going to open wonderful, wonderful place. Milk and honey. The taste of prosperity, opportunities born of alternativity, nurturing and abundancy. Nurturing that your needs will be met. You have entered a sweet time in your life, enjoying the land of milk and honey that everyone wants to experience. It's an indulgency that feels more lavish than ambitious. when all your senses are awakened to the ultimate possibilities in the universe. These times and precious and only come once when you are in your alternative zone. Wearing the world as a loose garment, not wanting, yet able to be nurtured in ways both tangible and stable. Abundance is an energy that you are living a part of. All your needs are being met. You are given the gifts of nurturing in every form. Congratulations, you guys. Congratulations. I want to say to each and every person, life is about to wake up, get up, move for you guys. Enjoy this energy. Understand what is happening to you in this week. And I'm saying namaste until next week.